Jeff Lafferty here, and today I'm flying solo. Tristan's asleep. We just got back from a long walk, and he's out, so I'm getting some work done. This week I've been working on a cover for Bluewater Entertainment, and it's a cover for their Adam West comic called The Misadventures of Adam West. And if you don't know who Adam West is, he's the guy who played Batman back in the 60s. Very cool. As you can see, I've got the color sprayed on it. I'm working on the face. I've got lots of Adam West reference photos around so that I could get his likeness. Also, I've got the mats I cut, sprayed, laying every which way, heads and hands and everything, trying to keep the color in the right spot. You know, the blues in the blue spot and the reds in the red and all that stuff. In my crazy way of painting with an airbrush. I'm really excited about this cover. It's going to be the first time my work's really been on the comic book stands in about 11 years. The last time I was in a comic, it was a book called X-Men Millennial Visions, and I did two kind of not very good pinups. Back then I was just, you know, in a different style, in a different mode. I think I was trying to fit into comics, and that never works. So this time around, I feel like I've got a better shot at actually maybe making this work, because I feel like my style is a lot more representative of myself and who I am. I've always liked Adam West. I was kind of excited when I heard that it was this, because, you know, it's kind of an opportunity to do something that I probably wouldn't do on my own. I definitely watched the Batman TV show back in the day, and I liked it myself. I like the new movies, you know, the more darker, serious ones. I like the comics. I love, you know, Frank Miller's take on Batman with The Dark Knight and all that. But I think everybody's got that kind of nostalgic thing for that, the 60s TV show. With this piece, I just tried to kind of, the instructions were, do Adam West as a secret agent. I really didn't get a look at the interior story or anything. So I kind of had to just wing it. I came up with kind of like a sort of all-purpose image that would kind of work with lots of different things, depending on what's in there. So I kind of picked this motif of him in a very kind of James Bond-esque type pose. The sketch I turned in was a little bit different. It was the basic concept, but I, as you can see here, I had him pointing the gun straight at the viewer. And when I actually sat down to really draw that and try to get it to work right, it just didn't fit. It didn't fit. It really didn't read. Even though I do like this design, I think that the design I went with is a little better, because his shoulders kind of frame the smaller figure instead of just it being a bullseye right at his chest, which, you know, that's, I know they say don't do a design like that, but I think that a lot of times a bullseye is actually a great design. But anyway, in this case, where the gun is kind of pointing out at a kind of an erratic angle, it just cuts that design. It takes like a simple design and makes it a little bit more complex. I also kind of just, I like the figure here. I mean, it seems more 60s kind of secret agent sort of stance. You know, I could see the guy from the Avengers taking the stance, or even like the Thin Man maybe. All in all, I think it came out pretty well. That pretty much wraps this one up. If you guys like the videos, rate, comment, subscribe. If you want to ask me a question, just ask it in the comments. I'll try to answer it in one of my future videos. Thanks, and I'll see you guys next time.